Hey guys, this is Alan from the GovCast Bunker, and today I'm gonna do another tutorial video, and today the tutorial video will be on the course Santa Ventura. Santa Ventura you can find on tour 7 and you can find it on tour 2. It's one of the older courses that's been around for a long time, so I know most of you are familiar with it. You might or might not know the little ins and out of this course, but I will, like my normal videos, go through this course hole by hole and discuss the different possibilities, how to play the holes, and the do's and don'ts. So yeah, let's get started. The first hole on Santa Ventura is a par 4 hole. And one thing that's slightly different with the Santa Ventura course is that you actually don't have a lot of options how to play. A lot of holes you have a right option or a left option. This is a bit more straightforward, and this course is more about hitting the ball right, making the right spin and making the right curl to get the ball where exactly where you want. So on the first hole here, the hole one, the best you can do, and again let me just start by saying that this tutorial is to make a minimum a birdie, but hopefully eagle. So if you are just gonna play this course on par, this tutorial is not for you. So again, let's get started. The first hole is a par 4, and you will start from the middle tee, and you will tee off. And the best way to basically hit your shot is to hit it here. You don't wanna hit it here, and at this point in time you should have big enough clubs to basically get over here. So you wanna hit it here, and you wanna basically don't give it a full top spin. You wanna give it enough spin so you end up around here. I normally spin it to the right and I slice it slightly depending on the wind. If you hit more over here, you need to slice it slightly more to get it up here. If you hit it up here, again, side spin will probably get it down here. Once you're here, it's a pretty straightforward shot. Basically, you shoot it over the bunkers, and you should be able to land on the green. And if you're really lucky, you should be able to actually get it in. The green here curves on this side here. The green basically curves. So if you hit it here, the ball are gonna go down towards the hole. The thing you have to be careful about here is when you hit your first shot and you land here, if you curve it too much, you are gonna end up in the rough here. And the second thing to worry about is if you put too much topspin on it, you're gonna end up in the bunker here, which is gonna make it much, much more difficult for you to basically get in the hole on that second shot. Hitting the green from either here or here should be no problem, but again, you definitely will not be able to eagle that shot if you do that. So anyway, let's move on to the second hole. The second hole is a par 3 hole, and I'm sure you know this hole from the shootouts. I know me personally, I played this hole number of times in the shootouts. Again, here also, I only believe there's one real option, good option to play this hole, and that's basically to position yourself when you take a first shot, land around here. I normally do not curl this shot, I just use spin, because it basically, there's a slight hill, so when you hit here, the ball are automatically going to go down towards the hole. This is more about spinning it right, so your ball goes towards the hole, and also stopping the ball so it doesn't go out here in the rough around here. It is possible to get a hole in one on this. I have had a few hole in ones on this hole, and it's one of the easier holes. So if you get this in a shootout, you should be pretty happy. But remember, if it's easy for you, it's also easy for your opponent, of course. Let's move on to hole three. Hole three is a par 5 hole. It's as you can see, it's quite a long hole, And again, there is no right or left. There's only one way you can go, and that's just down that fairway. What you should do is you should try and position yourself so you land your shot around here. Why I say here and not, let's say, here is that when you land here, what I normally do is I spin and curl my shot to the left. So in the end of the day, once I hit here, my ball will end up here. If you put too much topspin, there is a slight chance you might hit up in this bunker here. And if you don't curl it right or land up too much up here, you will end up in the rough around here. On this second shot, it's pretty straightforward. This is a hole where there's a high possibility you can actually get an eagle. The second shot is pretty straightforward. You will shoot. You should land around here and then just roll it in towards the hole on the green here. If you shoot too far, your ball are going to overshoot the green and you are going to end up in the rough here. Again, pretty straightforward shot. I'm mostly eagle this shot because it's a long shot, but it's actually a fairly easy shot. Even if you land up in the rough here or in the bunker here, you will still be able to reach that green. It's just going to be so much harder to basically get a eagle on this one. Anyway, let's move on to hole 4. Again, hole 4 is a par 3. You probably know this hole from a lot of shootouts. And in this hole, you actually have a right or left option. I will not say any of these options are better than the other. I normally prefer the right option simply because it's very uneven on the left side. So if you shoot it here to the left, you have to be really accurate with your wind. If you're not accurate with your wind, because this is, it's very bumpy, so a little mistake on the wind can suddenly send the ball, instead of going towards the hole, the ball will go up here or the ball will go down here. It's very unpredictable. But if you shoot it to the right, it's a bit more even it's on a hill, it's very much more even. So if you are slightly inaccurate on your wind calculations, the ball will still go in the direction of the hole. I normally shoot it to the right. What I'll do is I will just use the spin basically. There's no need to curl it because you're going to hit a slope on a hill. So the ball will go towards the hole. The trick here is to stop it near the hole and of course also don't overshoot the hole. Basically, the trick on this shot is the power of your shot to get it to stop near the hole. This is another hole where I've had hole-in-ones a few times. It's a pretty straightforward hole. I know somebody's going to say, well, you can also shoot it from the middle here. Yes, you can, but a lot of times what happens is you're going to end up over here. You can put in the comments what you feel about that. I have shot it a lot of times here, but I always seem to end up in this bunker here. So I don't advise that. I advise you even take the right option or the left option. And again, I advise the right option here. Anyway, let's move on to hole number 5, which is another par 5 hole. Okay. Again, long hole, pretty simple shot. If you have tailwind on this shot, and basically a good club, a very ball with extra power, you can land your shot here. I don't advise that, so let me get to that. I will advise you always take the shot in a way where you land here. Then what will happen is your ball will jump over this little creek here, and you're going to land on this side. If you do not curl it and side spin it, and you put too much top spin it, you're gonna end up here in this rough, which is gonna create a problem. I'll explain that later. Mostly, what you do is you hit it here, you curl it to the left, you give side spin, you will land around here, and your ball will roll around, and you should be around here. The more you are to the left on the fairway, the better, because these trees here are going to create a problem if you end up to the right on this fairway. The second shot is again pretty straightforward depending on where you are. If you are to the right of this fairway, you will notice that you cannot shoot directly through the hole because the trees will be blocking your shot. So what you will have to do is you will have to shoot over here, and then you will have to curl the shot really strongly to the right to basically get it on that green. If you're here, it's fairly easier, then it's just a straight shot past this tree line. You're gonna land here, try and land here, try not and land on the actual green, because if you land on the green, you're gonna come in too fast, you're gonna end up here in the rough. But if you land around here, let it jump onto the green, then it will go towards the hole. Again, the caveats here is literally the bunker here, and this side here. Most people end up here and then it gets messy. Then you basically cannot do an eagle on it. It will be a birdie or a par. So try and go easy on the first shot. I know it's sometime when you have a good tailwind, oh, it's like you really feel like landing here and then just shoot it out there, but you're gonna end up here and it's gonna get messy. Just take it easy on the first shot and then give it all you got on the second shot. Let's move on to hole 6. Hole 6 is a par 4 hole. This is actually this is one of those holes. It's actually a very difficult hole. There's two ways you can shoot this shot depending on the wind. A lot of times in this hole you will have a lot of tailwind. You're talking 7, 8, 9, 10 tailwind. And of course the logical thing will be to shoot here, slice it and curl it to the right, spin it to the right. The only thing about that is this: your top spin. You will need top spin to get over this bunker. There's a bunker here. If you give it too much, you're gonna end up, of course, on the green, and your ball is gonna set you up over here in the rough or in this bunker. If you give it too little, you're gonna end up in this bunker. So it's really tricky because it really depends on the ball, and you have to hit it right, spin it right. You can also gonna give it full curl. If you do that, you're gonna end up in here. But if I have a 3 or 4 tailspin, I will normally go here, curl it, slice it, and then I'm gonna end up on the green. Another way to go is to basically shoot straight, try and land about the middle here, and then you curl it all you can to your left. And what will happen is your ball will fly through these trees and land either on the rough, on the fringe, or if you're really lucky, directly on the green here. If you're really, really unlucky, of course, you're gonna get stuck in these trees, and if you get stuck between a tree trunk, well, do I need to say more? Then there's not much you can do. If you really wanna play it conservatively, land to the left here, stop the ball and stay on this little piece of fairway here, and then make a nice shot directly on the green and try and get it in. But we all know once we are there, we're gonna go for that green because we can smell that green on this hole. But it's a very interesting hole. I actually like playing the hole, but it's a bit of hit or miss if I win, simply because of what can happen. But that is also what makes this hole so interesting. Let's move on to hole 7. Hole 7 is a par 3. Again, I'm sure you're all very familiar with this hole. Again, this is one of the shootout holes you see a lot. There's two ways to play this. There is the right option and the left option. I normally play the right option, and the right option is basically to land on this little fairway here, which is the second one, and then put backspin on the ball and then land on the green. The trick here is to not get too eager. You rather want, if you give it too much, if you don't give it enough backspin, basically, it's not about giving it topspin. If you don't give it too much, enough backspin, it's gonna pass the hole. And here, there is a slope. And if it hit that slope, it is gonna roll all the way down here, especially on the shoot-offs. It's gonna roll down here, and you're gonna be about 10 to 14 yards away from the hole. What I normally do is I give it backspin and I stop it just before the hole. Of course, I'm trying to get it in, but I will stop it before the hole always. I rather get a 1 or 2 or 3 yards from the hole, but before the hole. If you get 2-3 yards after the hole, I can tell you already, it's gonna roll down here and that's it, your game over. The second way to shoot this is, of course, is the harder way, is to make a straight shot, overpower it slightly, land around here, spin it, curl it, and what will happen is your ball will bounce here, 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 because this is actually a hill. So this hill will help you turn the shot, and it will roll up here on the green towards the hole. Again, why it's difficult is in the end, your ball is going to roll up that hill on the green, and to basically get it right in the shootout, or get it close in the shootout, is really, really difficult, because there's just so many things going on if you shoot that left shot there. But again, I've seen people shoot it on the left. I've seen people get it really close to the hole. I guess if you practice enough, you will get good at it. But I also know that most people play it to the right. They will go for this little fairway here, and then they will basically shoot straight, try and jump over the bunker here and get it straight on the green. Again, here, careful. It's very narrow, the fairway. You normally have a lot of side wind. Just make sure you hit that little fairway here. Also, try not and position your shot all the way to the top of the fairway. I normally like to land in the middle, so I don't end up in the bunker here by accident. And then I just make sure that I hit that green. And don't come in too fast. That's really, really important on this shot. Anyway, let's move on to hole 8. Hole 8 is a par 4. And it's a, I find this one of the most more difficult, not the most, but the more difficult holes in Golf Clash. There's basically, I found there's two ways to play it. There's a safe way, and there's a bit more, not to say not so safe way, but a harder way. It depends again a bit on the wind. If I have very little crosswind, like 5, 6, 7, I will shoot it directly, and I will hit the start of this fairway. I will put a bit of backspin. I will not be too brave here, put a bit of backspin, and I will try and just position my ball around here, because that's enough, that's all you need. Again, be careful, this is a very narrow fairway here, and most people who take this shot, if you don't hit this fairway, and your ball land here in the middle, you are going to get out here, or you are going to end up here in this bunker, or in the rough here. And that's a problem, because you will not be able to make it to the green if you do that. So normally when I land here, I will try and stop my ball as fast as possible with backspin and end up here. Other way you can do is you can shoot a bit more to the left. It's not a very long shot. You shoot it here and you try and stop the ball right in the middle here. The more to the right, the better, but try and stop it here. Because on the second shot, if you have a good enough club, of course, you should be able to, like me, I'm able to shoot from here and hit this fairway here, and then jump over the water and actually get it to the green. If you have landed here, if you took the right and landed here, it's a really easy shot. You just shoot straight. You land on the fairway here, it will jump over and it will hit the green. Again, the only thing you have to be careful here is the speed. Don't come in on that green too fast. If you do that, you are going to end up in the rough here. Again, it's funny, it's a par 4 hole, and when you see the hole, it's quite a difficult hole. I know also what people say, yeah, but if you're here, you can also shoot it this way. Yes, you can. You can shoot it across here, spin it a bit and come down here. But if you're here anyway, you might as well go full on and go this way. It's much, much easier. Again, in the comment, tell me in the comments if you have other ways or better ways to play this hole. Again, this is just how I play it. This is just my experience with these holes. Let's move on to the last hole. The last hole is par 5. Again, it's a long hole. And this is a hole where you really need to know how to curl your shots. See, the first shot, there's actually only one option. And that is to try and land it here. Even if I don't use full speed, because of the, if I have tailwind or anything, it doesn't matter, land it here. If I have side spin, you can land it a bit more up here. I normally give it top spin, 2-3 max. Don't give it too much. Then what I do is, I put left side spin, I put left curl, maximum curl, and then I take a perfect shot. Don't overpower the shot, just position it here and try and get a perfect shot. What will happen is your ball will land here, you will jump over here and you should end up over here. If you have too much topspin, what will happen is you're gonna end up in the rough here. If you don't curl it enough, I can tell you, you're gonna end up in the bunker here. On this second shot is where it gets a bit more difficult. When you are here, you have two options. You can either go here and try and hit the green, or you can take the easier way, which is basically shoot it straight, curl the shot, and end up here. I normally, 9 out of 10 times, try and get my ball so I land around here, and then I curl it to the right. I give it 2 or 3 topspin. What will happen is the ball will turn and I will end up on the green here. If you put too much topspin, you are going to end up in this bunker here. If you put too much curl, you're going to end up in this bunker here. If you put too little curl, you're going to end up in this bunker here. So you start to get the picture. This is not an easy hole also. The second shot here is really, really tricky. That's why I notice a lot of people now like to play here, shoot here, shoot here. But you will not get on the green in second shot. But what you will get is in your third shot, you will from here, you have a very good position to the hole. You have such a good position that you can actually eagle it. You see, if you don't make this a perfect shot, then and you are in this bunker, or you're in this bunker, or you're in this bunker, or maybe you're in this bunker, it's going to be really hard to eagle it. And also, if you're in this bunker or this bunker, when you shoot up on the green kind of curves down. So it's very hard to stop the ball. And even shooting from here, sometimes you end up over here and it's just going to get really, really messy. It's one of those holes, like, once you master it, you master it. And you can do it anytime. I like this hole now because I normally win on this hole because I'm very good. And I always shoot here and I almost manage to get it up here every time and winning. If there's too much wind or if I made a mistake on my first shot, I will always go this way around. Anyway, thank you for viewing my video. Please hit that subscribe button. Please like the video. Please comment if you have any other, if you don't agree with me, or maybe you have better ways to play some of the holes, please let me know. Thank you so much. I see you in my next video. Bye.